Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it.
Praise the name of the Lord. It's a new day, and we want to bless the Lord for giving us the privilege to see today, which is Wednesday, May 29, 2019. We bless the Lord for what He did in our lives yesterday. I know that the blessings will be permanent. I want us to pray. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. We just want to say, Baba O Eshe. We just want to say, Baba O Eshe. I just want to say, Baba O Eshe. I just want to say, Baba O Eshe. Father, I want to say thank you for the privilege to see a new day. Thank you for watching over us in the night. Thank you for giving us the privilege to see a new day. Accept our praises in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for all our viewers. And thank you also for the life of our spiritual parents, Daddy and Mommy Gio, Pastor Enoch Adejare Adeboye, and Pastor Mrs. Folu Adeboye. Thank you for giving them the grace, O God, to be vessels unto honor, even to this generation, and in your hands. We want to say thank you. I said our praises in Jesus' mighty name. Father, as we go through the pages of the scriptures this morning and studying these open heavens, we pray that you will bless every one of us. And let your name alone be honored and glorified. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody, I want to welcome you into another day. Today, we are looking at the topic that says, you are very precious. You are very precious. And I want to say, I am very precious. And say to yourself out there, I am very precious. You are very precious. Because you are very precious, I want to call you Your Excellency. You will get there. You may look at yourself and begin to say, what is this man saying? I'm not the one that is saying it. It is the Almighty God. He's saying that you are precious. You are precious to Him. You are special. Share to Him. You are honorable to Him. You are an eternal excellency. Now the memory verse says it all. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of Him who hath called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. Let's go through the memory verse together. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of Him who hath called you out of darkness into His Marvelous light. Now look at the grammar there. Chosen generation. That tells you that you are precious. A royal priesthood. That tells you that you are precious, very precious. A peculiar nation, an holy nation. That tells you that you are special and precious. A peculiar people. You are different from all other people. You are special. You are precious. I pray that that will be so for all of us in Jesus' name. The passage we are considering, we are reading, is 1 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 15 to 20. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 15 to 20. Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. Verse 18, flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body. But he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? Verse 20. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. You are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. You are very precious. I am very precious. We are very precious. You are bought with a price. Hallelujah. Now, let me read from the Open Heavens Devotional here. The abnormal use of a thing is what is referred to as abuse. There is a normal use and there is an abnormal use. If you use something abnormally, you call it abuse. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. My body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Don't abuse that body. I pray in the name of Jesus, what God is saying concerning you will be real, that you are very precious, that I am very precious. That's why I know that nobody can possibly tamper with your life as from today, because I know you are going to obey what you are hearing, listening to. You are going to do everything that you need to do to obey every instruction. Now, it is unfortunate that many people abuse themselves in different ways. For example, it is an abnormal use of the body and mind when one works without taking time to rest, all in a bid to maximize earnings or turnover. That is true. The Almighty God, the creator of heaven and earth, when he created everything, the Bible says he rested. Now, so many people who claim to be children of God, they want to look for money at all costs, so much that even on Sunday, on the Lord's Day, they want to go and cut a job somewhere. Take note of what I'm saying. Cut job, that's quote and unquote. Normally, they, Monday to Friday, that's when they work. But the only day that they should use to rest and to serve their God, they want to see, find a way of doing something so that they can maximize money. They can maximize profits, so to say. I pray that the Almighty God will give you understanding, and I pray that you will not die before your time. Many people have lost their lives because they want to make it at all costs within the shortest time possible. If you know how precious you are, you will not burn the candle of your life from both ends. You are precious. Today, in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 15, the Holy Spirit is asking you whether or not you realize that your body is a part of Christ. 1 Corinthians 6, 15. He says, know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Maybe you don't know that God is trying to wake you up. Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? What is the Almighty God say? In other words, even the body we call ours actually belongs to Jesus Christ. Somebody can say, what are you saying? I own my body. You don't own your body. Your body belongs to Jesus Christ. This tells you how precious we are in the sight of the Lord. As children of God, we are so unique. We are so unique that we are joined to God in one spirit should gladden our hearts and make us shun any form of defilement. No wonder. The psalmist says in Psalm 139 verse 14, Psalm 139 verse 14, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knoweth right well. It's one of the memory verses that I love. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. God has created you fearfully. He has created you wonderfully. Scientists, they understand this place better. If they examine you, they look at your composition. If they tell you what is in your body, you'll be able to praise this God better. You are fearfully and you are wonderfully made. Created in the image of the Maker of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul know it right well. When we abuse our body, we are actually trampling under our feet a precious pearl the Lord gave to us. Not only because we are created in His own image, but because He also paid a high price to redeem us from the curse of sin and death. Praise the Lord. You are not only created in His own image, He paid a high price to redeem us from the curse of sin and death. We are even much more precious than the first Adam. Why? Because we are bought with a price that cannot be valued. Don't devalue yourself. You are precious. I can't devalue myself because I'm precious. You devalue yourself when you go into sin. When you dip your hands in sin, in iniquity, you devalue yourself. You debase yourself. Hallelujah. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will open our eyes of understanding today. In the name of Jesus. Our Lord has called us out from darkness. That's 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Into the marvelous light of holiness, prosperity, and great deliverance from the power of sin and Satan. We must therefore do what? We must therefore glorify God in our body and in our spirit man. We are like the beloved wife of a king. We are like the beloved wife of a king. The queen does not comport herself in ways that will bring ridicule to the royal family. Her husband in particular. Moreover, a queen does not tell lies because she has integrity. Sleeping around is a ridiculous thing to do as a Christian. Sleeping around is a ridiculous thing to do as a Christian. Maybe you have been sleeping around. You have been fooling around. This must stop us from today because you are a very precious vessel. Because you are very precious in the hands of the Almighty God. You are very precious. Others may be doing it. You can't afford to do it. Even if you are not married to any person, you are joined to Jesus Christ. Take note. You still single? Trusting God for your life partner? If you are not married to any person yet, you are joined to Jesus Christ, who is the husband of the church. Aren't you happy? You are not cheap. You've been bought with a price. Beloved, do you know you are more valuable to God than angels? That's another level. You are more valuable to God than angels. Angels are ministering spirits. They are to serve you. The Bible says you will even judge angels according to 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 3 there. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 3. That's wonderful. We will even judge angels. The fact that God has given you his precious Holy Spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing you of things to come, should tell you how precious you are to him. Hallelujah. Even the angels are mystified by the great benevolence of God to us and by the fact that he has set us over the world to come. You can see this in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 12. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 12. And Hebrews chapter 2, verse 5 to 8. Hebrews chapter 2, from verse 5 to 8. If you are armed with this knowledge, what should be your response? Armed with this knowledge, if I were you, I would jealously guard my salvation. We can't afford to lose our salvation. Lest I lose my worth and become a castaway. Because we are armed with this knowledge, we should guard our salvation jealously. We can't afford to lose our worth. We can't afford to devalue ourselves, debase ourselves, and become a castaway. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 27. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 27. Let's see what the Bible says. The Bible says, "But I keep under my body." That's Paul the apostle. "But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by enemies, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a cast away. I keep under my body." That's discipline. "And bring it into subjection." Self-discipline. "Lest that by enemies, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway." How can you call yourself a child of God and you are found among harlots? Does he speak well of you? Does he glorify God? You sleep with anybody. You say because you are not married, you have become a public dog. That must stop. As of today, you are very precious. I am very precious. Years ago, when I was serving my nation as a youth corporal, because as a graduate you have to serve your country for 1 year, I was posted somewhere. I was posted to a village to teach in a secondary school. I remember that my first day there, boys came around, and right away I began to preach Christ to them, giving them tracts, witnessing to them. Some of them, because they had an expectation, because we were told that once a youth corporal gets there, one or two girls can attach themselves to him, serving him. You know what that means. But as I was giving trust to them, a few of them, which means this man, this is a different person. We thought this man will understand. I am a child of God. I can't afford to drag myself in the mud. You are very precious. But that's not the end of it. I remember that a fellow copper in another village impregnated one of the students, one of the girls, and took the lady to the dispensary or the maternity there to abort. And I had to rebuke him. I said, "Why? Having preached to him, I said, this can't happen. If you say you're a child of God, there must be a difference." He looked at me and said, "Well, Mr. So-so-so, don't you know that this is bush allowance for you?" I said, "It can't happen." I said, "How can I call myself a child of God and a teacher to these students, and then they will see my nakedness?" I said that will never happen. He didn't see it that way. He said he was not looking at it that way. I said, "That's the way I look at it. I can't lower my integrity. I can't devalue myself." Beloved, you are very precious. The prayer point is dynamic. It says, "Father, open the eyes of my heart to always see that Everything the devil and the world dangle at me pales in comparison to my value in Jesus' name. Father, open my eyes, open the eyes of my understanding to always see that everything the devil and the world dangle at me pales in comparison to my value in Jesus' mighty name, that they are nothing to be compared with the value that you have. I don't know what the devil is trying to show you so that he can devalue you. You are not available. I say that one. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are not available to Satan. Things must change for better from today. The hymn for today, hymn number 4, says, "Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of thy love. Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for thee." Swift and beautiful. Hallelujah. "Take my voice and let them sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from thee. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite will I withhold. Take my intellect and use every path thou shalt choose." Hallelujah. The last stanza there says, "Take my love, my Lord, I pour. At thy feet is treasure store. Take myself and I will be ever only all for thee." Shall we please pray? Father, we thank you for speaking to us again. We appreciate the fact that we are not bastards because we have been adopted. We are bought with a price. And we know that no power can devalue any one of us as from today. By the reason of what we have heard, O God, we pray that you give us the boldness and the grace to say no to Satan, to sin, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. None of us will fall by your grace. As many as are repenting now, Father, please forgive them in the mighty name of Jesus. Give them a new beginning. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain.